Paige, it's Elliot.
Elliot, what a pleasant surprise.
I hope you don't think I've forgotten about you, but I wanted to give you a day to settle into the suite before I called. How are things going?
Just fine.
I take it you're back at the top of the World Club, then?
Yes, I started last night.
Well, this is going to sound rather odd, particularly since you just started to work last night, but I was wondering if you could take the night off, or at least part of the night.
Why?
Because I'd like to take you up on that dinner offer you made.
It's too bad about Max Decker.
Yeah, it really is.
According to the papers, he doesn't look too good.
I know. Elena called me from the hospital. She said Max was hurt pretty bad.
And from what the papers said, he's just lucky to be in one piece.
Elena said he barely had a scratch on him. It's all on the inside. I just hope everything turns out all right.
Yeah. Well. Oh, sorry there, buddy, but we're not open yet.
Oh, boy, just what I need right now.
What?
It's all right, Roy. The guy's not a customer. He's a cop. Michaels, ain't it? New York police.
That's right. Feel that you're right, right?
What can I do for you?
I'd just like to ask you a couple questions.
I already told you everything I know about Joe Foster. You're just wasting your time.
Oh, maybe so. You ever see that bag before?
Where'd you get that?
Joe's, isn't it?
Yeah, it's mine, all right.
Well, it was found last night on a dead man. A man named Gus Perkins.
Leave you.
You don't hold out much hope for Max, do you?
No. No, I don't, to be honest with you. Frankly, I'm surprised that he survived the operation.
Does Rena know how you feel?
Oh, no, of course not. I've been very cautious with her. She's so optimistic. I know how hard she's fighting for him to pull through this.
Maybe he will pull through.
Hi.
Hi. You just missed the surgical team.
Mm-hmm. They all troop in?
Mm-hmm.
Well, they like to travel together.
Max still hasn't opened his eyes. It's been hours since he came up from the ICU.
Well, it takes time, Rena.
If he would just open his eyes, that would be a good sign, wouldn't it?
Yes. Yes, it would. Listen, why don't you go in the sitting room and try to get some rest?
I can't leave Max.
Won't do any good for you to get sick.
I'm going to be just fine.
I've got to make some rounds. I'll be back soon.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Beverly McKenzie.
Oh, you must be exhausted.
I think I'm just too numb to be tired. But what happens if Max...
Elena, don't do it. He's gonna be all right. Hey, what happened to the spunk that you had when I got shot, huh?
I don't know.
Well, look, you know he's gonna have much better medical care than I did. Gulf Coast's a great, great hospital. He's gonna pull through.
Yeah, but the doctor says that his condition is worse.
Oh, look, Elena, just stop thinking about it. I'm glad to see you. I missed you.
I missed you, too. Oh, I was so afraid that I was going to come back here and you weren't going to be here.
Elena, I love you. I'm never going to leave you.
Yeah, but if the police find you, they're going to put you in jail and you're not going to have any choice.
Well, we're just going to have to take care of that.
Your arm.
Yeah, I took off the bandage.
The tattoo is gone.
Yeah, I told you that salt would work.
Yeah, Dr. McAllister said you could have died from that infection.
Hey, I'm too mean to die.
Oh. What are we going to do about Gus? You think he's going to come looking for his money?
Well, that's another reason I couldn't leave the country yet. Yeah, he's going to come back looking for that money.
What are we going to do?
Well, I've been thinking about that. I got a couple of ideas, but look, before we start talking about it, I'm going to fix you a cup of coffee. You look beat.
Okay, that would be nice.
You just relax there on the couch, okay?
Okay.
You know, I've been getting pretty good at this. I think all the time working at the diner really paid off in more ways than one. Say, I got an idea. What do you think about this? We go down to Mexico, we open up our own place. We'll call it Joe's Diner.
Joe?
What? What is it? What's wrong?
It's Gus. He's dead.
Isn't this the bag that Joe Foster used to transport $1 million after he'd abducted Elena Decker?
That's right. So what's this Gus Perkins guy doing with it?
That's what we'd like to know. Thought you may be able to give us a few answers, since it was your bag to begin with.
Well, Joe, that repairman ever come by to fix the ice machine?
Yes, sir. He was here about an hour ago.
That's good. That's all we'd need. Be without ice on a day like this must be over 100 degrees out there. Well, Detective Michaels.
Hello, Mr. Parnell.
What brings you to the coup?
They're asking more questions about Joe Foster.
What, you haven't caught that guy yet? Well, I figured with the New York police on the job, you'd have nabbed him by now.
Well, I'm sorry to shatter your belief in our expertise, Mr. Parnell. The way things are going, though, we may never find him.
Why? Why's that?
The police found this, bag on some dead man last night. This is the bag that Joe Foster used when he took $1 million from my apartment.
And you figured that Foster killed the guy for the money?
No, Perkins was hit by a car. The man who hit him claims he felt his car roll over something. Then he looked up just in time to see somebody dash in front of his car. Apparently, Perkins was killed going for this bag.
And the bag was empty?
Uh-huh. We figure Foster has the money and had left town by now.
$1 million.
Yeah. He must be halfway around the world by now.
Yeah, I wouldn't doubt it. Well, that's tough, Detective Michaels.
Mr. Parnell, if you don't mind, I'd like to talk to you about some money that, Andy and I have been working on some arrangements for Elena. We need the money for that.
That's going to have to wait, Billy Joe. I've got an important business meeting and I just remembered. I won't be long. It was good seeing you again, Detective Michaels. If you have any more questions, you know where to reach me.
Certainly.
I'd love to have dinner with you, Andy.
Is tonight okay?
Sure, fine. What time?
Well, that's up to you. I'm more or less flexible.
Oh, could we do it early and then I could go back to the club later on and help Alfredo?
Yes, early's fine. I have some work to do, but I can always come back to the office after dinner.
If it's inconvenient, we can do it another day.
No, it's fine, really.
Well, good. It wouldn't be a problem, but it's my first day back at work.
I understand completely. How does 6 o'clock sound?
Fine. I'll look forward to seeing you then.
Me too.
Well, I'll see you at the suite at 6 then.
Great.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Well, Dennis, how are you?
Fine. I hope I didn't barge in the middle of your phone call.
Oh, that's all right.
Was that Paige you were just talking to?
Yes, it was.
The two of you are going out tonight?
Yes. I was feeling guilty about not having talked to her since Iris allowed her to move into the suite. I didn't want her to think we'd abandoned her.
No, of course not.
I don't know what you did to change Iris's mind, but whatever it was a wonderful thing you did.
I suppose it was.
Oh, I mean it, Dennis. It meant a great deal to Paige to have her job back. You've helped her a great deal. She almost sounded like her old self on the phone just then.
Good.
So, how's work going?
Well, it's taking a little bit of an adjustment, but it shouldn't be too bad. I'm glad to be back.
Well, in the short time you were here before you went to jail, you must have made a favorable impression. Several of the reporters have come in just to tell me how happy they are to have you back.
It's great to be back.
I can't tell you what all this has meant to me. Having the murder charge cleared, the two of us working together at KVIK. I'm on top of the world.
Well, I was hoping we could celebrate tonight, but I can see Paige has already beaten me to it.
Well, there's no reason why you can't join us.
I'd rather not.
Well, I understand, Dennis. But I hope the day isn't far off and the three of us can be friends again.
Friends?
I don't think that's beyond the realm of possibility, do you?
No, nothing's beyond the realm of possibility.
Sweetheart, when we have a little boy and he grows up and he falls in love, maybe I'll give him this ring to give to his bride, to carry our love for another generation. How would you like that? Honey. Mama.
Mm-hmm.
Max opened his eyes.
Oh, that's wonderful, honey.
Yeah. It's a good sign, isn't it?
It's very encouraging.
He's not in pain, is he?
No, he's not, sweetheart. Iris just came by. She didn't want to disturb you, but she wanted you to know how very sorry she was to hear about Max. She brought some beautiful flowers.
That's sweet of her, considering the argument that we had.
Oh, she cares about you, Rena, and what happens to Max.
Max is going to be just fine.
Honey, why don't you go on out into the sitting room and try to get some sleep? I'll stay with Max.
No, I want to stay here.
But you're worn out.
I'm going to stay here until Max gets better.
All right.
I didn't notice Max had so much gray hair.
Maybe 20, 25 years from now, our sons and daughters will be having a barn dance just like we are right here tonight.
I'd like that.
Grow old along with me. The best is yet to be.
Best is yet to be, Max Decker.
What do you mean, Gus is dead?
It says right here that he was hit by a car trying to get that bag that I threw over the balcony. He thought the money was in it. I didn't want to kill him, Joe.
Elena, you didn't kill him. His own greed did that. We just should consider ourselves lucky that the police haven't connected him to us.
Yeah, but what if they do?
Well, I don't know. I don't think they will, though.
What happens if they talk to Jeannie at the diner? Gus used to work there.
We didn't give her our real names. They can talk to her all they want. No, I don't think there's any way the police are going to know how to trace us to Gus.
Well, what if they do?
We'll just have to cross that bridge when we come to it, Elena.
I better be getting back over to the hospital. I don't like to stay away for so long.
I wish there was something I could do.
I'm going to stop by the coop and tell Billy Joe that I'm not going to be able to sing there tonight.
Well, he won't expect you to.
I know that. but it's on the way, and I'd like to tell him in person. You know, he's been kind of worried.
Believe me, Elena, everything's going to be all right.
Max is all right, isn't he?
He's stable.
How long will the doctors be in there?
As long as it takes them to examine him.
I still don't know why I couldn't stay.
Now, honey, you'd just be in the way.
Mama, when Max wakes up, he'll expect me to be in there. I promise
you. It won't take long. Just try and relax.
I wish you'd try to get some sleep.
Oh, well, everyone stop telling me that. I'm sorry.
It's okay. It's okay. I understand.
Will you please tell me something else besides Max is doing as well as can be expected?
Well, there's really not much more to tell. Right now, the primary dangers are infection and more internal bleeding. It's only a possibility. I didn't say that it would happen.
Suppose it does happen.
Well, then I'll go back into surgery.
That's not going to happen, Doctor.
I hope not. I've got to run. I've got a seminar over at the medical school, but I'll check in with you just as soon as I get back.
Thank you very much. I don't know what we would have done without you.
Now, you eat something and then get some rest.
Okay.
I'll see you in a couple of hours. Dr. Timms will be in to speak with you just as soon as he finishes examining Max.
Thank you, Evan. She went out to the ranch to have supper with Kate. She'll be back in town soon.
Kate looked terrible when she came in to see Max today.
Well, Kate loves Max more than her own sons or grandsons, I think.
Mm. Max opened his eyes and smiled at Kate.
I know.
Mama?
Mm-hmm.
When Max leaves his hospital, we're going to stay with Kate until he can get up and move around on his own and do things for himself. That was Ginny's idea. What do you think of that?
It's a wonderful idea.
Mama. Thank you for taking care of me. Thank you.
You're welcome, sweetheart.
I'm really sorry about Max, Elena. I'm sure everything's going to be all right.
I hope so, Billy Joe.
Look, I don't want to keep you. I know you're in a hurry to get back to the hospital, but I just want you to know that, I don't want you to worry about a thing. I mean, you and Ricky, you know, can stay out as long as you have to, and if you don't feel up to singing tomorrow night, well, I'll just try and get somebody to sub for you for a while, right?
I always feel like I'm letting you down, you know?
No, come on, don't be ridiculous. Don't give it another thought, sweetheart, okay?
Well, thank you, Billy Joe. I appreciate it. Look, I guess I'd better get back over to the hospital.
Elena.
Oh, I was so sorry to hear about your brother.
How is he?
Thank you, Ruby.
Well, did Billy Joe tell you about all the excitement we had here today?
What excitement?
Ruby!
Didn't you tell her? Billy Joe, why do you want to keep that news from Elena? Now, she ought to know.
I didn't tell her because I didn't think it was important right now, Ruby, and I'd be just as happy if you didn't tell her either.
I just thought she should know since it involves her.
What involves
her? Never mind, sweetheart. It's nothing.
Well, with Billy Joe, I want to know.
Oh, Detective Michaels from the New York Police Department was here. He was asking more questions about Joe Foster, the guy that kidnapped you.
What kind of questions?
It seems they found that canvas bag that Foster took the money in.
Where did they find it?
It was found on some dead man across town. He was hit by a car. Well, look, sweetheart, all it probably means that Joe Foster's got the money back, so he's finally left Houston. So you just forget about the whole thing. It's all over and done with.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Well, of course I'm right. Now, look, you give me a call from the hospital when you get a chance. Let me know how things are going, all right?
I will.
Dang you, Ruby. What'd you go and tell her that for?
Okay, Foster. We're already alone.
I'm so glad you called this afternoon.
Well, I'm glad, too. I was only sorry about the other night that you couldn't have joined Dennis and Iris and me for Dennis's little victory celebration.
Well, I suppose Dennis must be ecstatic these days.
But I don't think Dennis knows quite what to make of it yet. You know, it must be rather a jolt to be preparing yourself for several years in prison only to find a mysteriously appearing confession has exonerated you completely.
Yes, I'm sure it seems rather unreal to him. Rather suspect, as if you might wake up and find yourself in prison after all.
Well, he's never voiced that fear, but I suppose it could have crossed his mind.
Elliot, has he ever remembered what happened in Crishaw's office that night?
No, I don't think he ever will. He'd been drinking, and apparently he hit his head on something when he and Chris fought. Anyway, it doesn't matter anymore. The important thing is that Dennis is a free man.
Could you help me with this, please? I've never been very good at that. I thought we'd have a glass of champagne and then talk about what we're going to order.
Oh, aren't we going down to the club for dinner?
Well, I thought it would be nicer if we ate up here. That would give us a little more time to talk. I think we have a lot to talk about.
Yes, we have, haven't we?
Hi.
Hi. I didn't know you were back. How are you doing?
Oh, I'm okay.
Ricky's with Max now. I thought they might want to have some time to themselves. Where's Mama?
I sent her home to have dinner with Stryker. She'll be back later. Did Max wake up yet?
He did this afternoon. He opened his eyes and he smiled at me, Jenny.
Smiled at Kate, too.
She told me that.
Oh, Ryan was here earlier. I feel so sorry for him. He feels terrible about not telling Max about the survey in time.
Well, if he had told Max about the new survey, then Max wouldn't have blown up the well.
I know. There was no way for him to have known what Max was planning. Damn, Jenny, I should have known myself.
I mean, Max didn't want you to know. It's that simple.
Yeah, we've never had any secrets from
Rena,
each other.
He knows that you would have done everything in your power to talk him
out of it. Yes, I would have, and he wouldn't be there now.
Rena, it's not your fault any more than it's Ryan's. It happened. And it's over. Now let's just forget about it and concentrate on Max's recovery. Mm-hmm.
The doctors are real encouraged.
Oh, yes? What'd they say?
That he's strong and healthy and that's in his favor. That's the main reason why he made it through the surgery.
Did you tell Vicky about our plans to have Max stay at Kate's when he was recuperating?
Yes, and Mama thinks it's a terrific idea.
I wonder if Max is going to think it's such a terrific idea when he gets roped into all those wedding plans.
Oh, I don't know. You know, as a matter of fact, Max and I were talking about it the other day, and he said that you should get married at the ranch, right on the front lawn.
Well, Ryan and I talked about that, too.
Kate would love it.
We'll have to talk to her about it. Will you be my matron of honor?
You bet I will.
I think Ryan wants to ask Max to be his best man.
I think he'll agree to that. Oh, and you better find a job for Stephen, you hear me?
Oh, boy, I want him to be involved in all the wedding plans. As a matter of fact, I talked to him this afternoon. He called me from camp.
Did you tell him about Max?
No. No, I told him about the well, but I didn't mention Max. I knew that he'd be too upset about it and he'd want to come home.
Good. Because Max is going to be out of the hospital before Steve gets home from camp. And there's no point in worrying him.
That's what I figured.
Max is going to recover from this, you know. I'm sure of it now.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Would you like an after-dinner drink, Eddie?
I shouldn't, Paige, not if I plan to get any work done tonight.
Oh, come on. You really don't expect to go to the office tonight, do you?
Well, not for long, but there are some things that if I don't finish, there won't be a morning news show.
Are you happy being back in journalism?
Well, when I'm away from it, I feel like a fish out of water.
I wish I knew how it felt to be dedicated to something.
Well, I've never thought of it as dedication. It's, well, actually, I don't know anything else.
Just from the way you talk about it, I don't know. I can just feel how much it's a part of you. That if you didn't do it, you'd be missing a part of yourself, part of your soul.
Well, it's part of me, but I think soul is exaggerating just a bit.
Maybe. I don't know. I think you'd be pretty good at anything you tried your hand at.
Oh, yeah, well, that's not exactly true.
No.
No. No, as a matter of fact, many years ago, I won't say exactly how many, I decided I would try something practical, something remunerative. So I tried my hand at selling real estate.
Real estate?
Yeah. Well, I can laugh about it now, too, but at the time it wasn't very funny.
Why, you didn't like it?
Well, it wasn't a question of liking. I just was terrible at it.
Oh.
In fact, if truth be known, I was a miserable failure.
Oh, Elliot, I can't believe that.
Well, believe it, because it's true. I was so bad at it that my boss gave me a bonus for quitting.
Oh, no.
This is absolutely true.
Oh, Elliot. Really, how much? Oh, that's wonderful. Oh. You know, this whole evening's been wonderful. I've forgotten what it felt like to laugh.
Yes, me too. You know, it's funny, I never realized until tonight that... Well, you and I have never really gotten a chance to know each other. I mean, we didn't exactly get off to a very good start. Then after that, you were always my son's wife, and I was your father-in-law.
And, in-laws rarely make good friends, right?
Rarely, but I think you must be an exception, Paige, because I do consider you a good friend. And I'm glad we're finally getting a chance to know one another even better.
I'm glad too, Ellie. Very glad. Are you cold?
No. I think you're cold because you're exhausted.
Mm. Would you like to lie down for a while?
No, I'm okay.
Well, your mom brought you a sweater this morning.
This'll do. Can you imagine Max wanting to wear this to the barn dance last night?
Well, he'll just have to save it. Maybe he can wear it to our barn dance when Ryan and I build our house. It'll be much cooler then.
I called Daddy to tell him to call the contractor to stop on our house. Do you think I was wrong, Jenny?
No, I think that Max should be there with you.
That house is as important to Max as it is to me.
I know.
Jenny, did Barrett ever tell you anything about Max's parents?
He used to talk about Max's dad all the time.
What about his mother?
I don't remember him mentioning much about Max's mother. Won't he talk about her?
I haven't asked him in a long while, but the only information he would give me is that she made this red shirt for him. Well, maybe when he's recuperating, he'll tell me all about her. Hmm?
Maybe. Would you like to go for a walk?
No, I don't think Elena's going to be very long. You know, she's in bad shape.
Boy, I've never seen her like that. I know she's upset about Max, but something else is very wrong. Jeb said so, and so did Ricky.
Well, it's just too bad that she's lost interest in her singing career.
Oh, Rena, when that girl decided that she wanted to be a singer, it was the most important thing in the world to her.
Well, maybe being kidnapped twice had a greater effect on her than we thought.
I don't know. But something's changed, that's for sure.
I don't know if you can hear me, Max. There's something I have to say to you. I know we haven't always gotten along. I guess we've both been pretty stubborn. You never understood why I wanted to leave the ranch and what a career meant to me. I guess I never understood what the ranch meant to you. But when I found out about you blowing up that well, I wanted to cry, Max. I never knew just how far you would go to protect your land, to risk your own life. But I know that now. And I just hope it isn't too late to tell you that I think it's wonderful to care for something so much and protect that something no matter what the cost is. You're a wonderful man, Max. And now you just gotta get better so I could tell you that to your face. So that I could tell you that I love you. That you're just about the best brother that anybody could ever want. Only I didn't know that till now.
Sorry.
What are you doing here so late?
Well, I just thought I'd hang around for a while and see how your date with Paige went.
It wasn't a date, Dennis.
Oh, whatever.
Paige and I had a very pleasant evening. It was good to see her enjoying herself.
Well, I'm surprised that Paige was able to get away from work at all to enjoy herself. Did you dine at the Top of the World Club?
No, we ordered up.
Well, I guess Paige must be happy to be back there.
Yes. She's very grateful to you.
Well, I was happy to do what I could, Dad. Did you have a good time?
Yes, we had a very pleasant evening. Unfortunately, I have all this to look forward to, but I was able to get away from it for a while at least.
You know, since you've got all that to do, I think I better get out of here because I don't want to, you know, disturb you while you're working. And if I don't get out of here in time, I'm not going to get to a restaurant to eat, so...
Dennis, do you mean you haven't eaten dinner?
Well, I had work to finish here.
Well, I feel badly. I wish you could have joined Paige and me, but... Well, I understand. Well, I'm sorry.
No problem.
Well, maybe we can have dinner tomorrow night.
Yeah, that's a good idea. I'll talk to you later.
You know, I'm beginning to get just a little bit upset about this business. I mean, Elena seems to be making a regular thing of these cancellations.
Yeah, but you got to understand, Mr. Parnell, these here are our special circumstances.
Well, yeah, of course, there's always an excuse, but what good does that do when business drops off?
Mr. Parnell, I've got a couple of great ideas that might help perk things up a little if Ricky and Elena can't come in. That is, if you want to hear them.
Well, boy, this is just what we need.
Mr. Parnell?
Oh, Detective Michaels.
Mr. Wright?
I hope you're here to tell us that you finally caught Joe Foster.
I'm afraid not. But we're getting close. We found out that Gus Perkins until recently worked at a place called Juan's Tex-Mex Diner.
Juan's Tex-Mex Diner? Mm-hmm. I've never heard of it.
It's like a dive.
Well, it's not exactly the sort of place we'd find in River Oaks. But according to the lady in charge there, a Miss Jeannie Halpern, he quit his job as chef there not long ago.
Well, what for?
He claims that a rich uncle left him a large sum of money. Point is, not long after he quit, another guy comes along and applies for his job as chef there. And right after that, this fellow's girlfriend comes along and gets a job as a waitress.
What's all this got to do with Joe Foster?
Well, this waitress had a date with Gus Perkins on the night that he was killed. Now, she may be the last one to see him alive.
Oh, wait a minute. I thought you said that she was the girlfriend of the guy who was the cook.
She was. But according to Miss Halpern, the substitute cook has a striking resemblance to Mr. Joe Foster.
Well, hey, that's great. That means all I got to do is nab the girl, and then you find that Joe Foster guy in no time flat, right?
Something like that.
Well, we sure appreciate you, we appreciate being updated on your search here for Mr. Foster, but if you don't mind me asking you, Mr. Detective here, I don't quite understand why you're telling all this to us.
Well, Joe Foster was in Mr. Parnell's employ there for a time, and I was just wondering if maybe Mr. Foster might have had a steady later friend that you knew about, Mr. Parnell.
Oh, well, wait a minute. You think that this guy at the diner might have actually been Joe Foster?
Was it my imagination that you called and asked me to take care of Alex Wheeler for you?
Maybe. In any case, it's just your word against mine.
Wrong, Parnell. I got a witness.
You mean your girlfriend?
Put that down.
Surprised at you, Joe.
Tell me, what's she like? None of your business what she's like.
Mr. Parnell?
What?
Was there a steady lady friend that Joe Foster had that you knew about?
I make it a point of staying out of my employees' personal lives.
But you said that Foster used to run errands for you.
To my knowledge, Joe Foster had no girlfriend. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have business to attend to.
How's your brother doing?
He's still unconscious. Oh, I have to get right back to the hospital, but I wanted to come see how you were doing.
I'm doing fine. Don't worry about me. What's wrong?
I'm afraid, Joe.
Afraid of what?
Afraid that I'm going to lose everyone that I care about. You and
Max.
That's not going to happen. You're not going to lose me. You're not going to lose Max.
You know, when I was sitting by Max before in the hospital, I had this feeling come over me, you know, coldness. It was like I knew that he was going to die.
Stop thinking like that. He's not going to die.
And then all I could think about was losing you, Joe.
Would you stop bringing up these demons, Elena? You got to start thinking positive.
Joe.
Yeah?
Detective Michaels from the New York Police Department is here. He was at the coop this afternoon. And he's here on special assignment to help track you down.
Did you speak to him?
No. No, Billy Joe did. Billy Joe said that they know about Gus. And they know that that bag that Gus had on him when he was killed is the same bag that you took from Billy Joe's apartment.
Well, that doesn't matter. It doesn't help them at all knowing that. There's no way they can trace that bag to us.
Yeah, but what if Jeannie in that diner says something?
Well, what can she say? She can say this woman that worked there named Helen Small went out with Gus the night he got killed.
And what about you? What is she going to say about you?
Well, that there was a cook there who was sweet on Helen.
Joe, you're in danger. And you have got to leave Houston.
But you can't leave.
But that doesn't matter.
It matters to me. You need me, Elena. Oh,
please, Joe.
Elena. All my life, I've been walking out on people. I ain't gonna do it anymore. I'm not gonna walk out on you. I don't care how dangerous it is.
Vicki. Hi, Jenny. Did you have a nice dinner with Stryker?
Oh, it was fine. Thank you. Rena in with Max?
Yes, Elena and Ricky were here earlier, but she thought maybe they'd like to be alone with Max, but she's been in the rest of the time.
Did you convince her to eat anything?
A piece of toast and a cup of tea was the best I could do. She was so cold earlier, Vicky, that she was shivering.
That's because she's completely exhausted, isn't that right, Evan?
Mm-hmm.
Head off. You seen Max tonight?
Yes.
You still don't have much hope for him, do you?
I have less than I had this afternoon.
Don't tell Rena that.
Honey, it might be kinder to tell her the truth.
Vicki, part of her knows the truth. But the other part refuses to admit it, and I don't want to take away from that optimism. Rena is fighting for Max's life almost as much as he is.
I've had patients that I thought would never recover, and they did. And I've also had patients that were well on the road to recovery, and they didn't make it. But maybe we should try to prepare Rena for the possibility...
No! Don't make her go through that. Maybe Max will pull through.
All right, honey.
Well, we're doing everything we can. The next 24 hours will be crucial. All we can do is continue to pray and wait and see.
I'm really looking forward to building our house. I'm going to make sure it's built right. I'm going to make that house. I'm going to build it so it lasts for generations.
If we don't have any children, it won't matter if the house lasts for generations or not. So long.
should think about having a family.
A family. But you never wanted to talk about that before.
I know. I wasn't ready before. But I've been thinking about it for a long time now. How would you like to be a dad? Honey?
I want to be a daddy.
I promise you, my darling, you will be a daddy.
I love you, Rena Decker.
And I love you, Max Decker. Max? 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 No. 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 No.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Texas.
Hi, Angela, Ruby.
Hello.
Hey.
Yes.
He's a little scared, but it's all.
Oh, I think he's just happy to be out of the hospital.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but not nearly happy as his parents are to have him back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Are you going to be all right? Are you sure?
Why, Max?
Good morning, Ryan.
Hi, Vicky. Is anything I can do for you? Any arrangements you want me to make?
No, thank you. Stryker's made tentative arrangements for the funeral. Although we want to check with Rena first.
She's still sleeping?
Yes, she went to sleep the minute we came home from the hospital last night.
She hadn't slept in 2 days.
How did she take it last night when she found out that Max was dead?
Before she went to bed, she asked me if I'd go to the hospital with her. She wanted me to wait with her until Max gets better.
You mean she hasn't accepted the fact that Max is dead?
No. She hasn't.
Thank you.
Here's those figures you wanted.
What's the matter with you?
Max Decker died last night. And he died while he was trying to blow up a well that you and Bubba were slant drilling on.
You're blaming me for Max's death?
No. No, I didn't mean that. I'm sorry.
I'm as sorry that Max died as anybody. I don't have time right now to be sentimental. I've got enough problems of my own to deal with.
What's wrong?
I can't find Bubba. I can't find him anywhere. I've looked for him all morning. I've called every honky-tonk in this town. Nobody's seen him.
Well, you've talked to him since the explosion, haven't you?
Suppose Bubba has left town because he knows there's still some way that they can prove. They can prove we were slant drilling, Ashley.
Starring Beverly McKenzie.
Is Maggie back yet?
Oh, not yet. She was so broken up over her nephew's death. I was hoping having a grandson back would make her feel a little better.
Grandson?
Well, that's the way Maggie feels about Billy Joe Jr.
Yeah.
See, Angela?
That's a legger. That's a good to find.
Oh! I think he really does like that. What'd you say to him?
Well, I asked him if he was glad to be back with his family and friends.
Well, I think he is. In fact, all the way back in the car, he was telling me how he was looking forward to a great big bowl of Maggie's chili.
See? Yeah.
Hey, where's his crib?
Oh, Robert hid it in the kitchen.
Again, do you know where he put it?
He folded it up and put it somewhere. Let's
okay,
go ask him.
Let's go.
Come on, buddy.
Bye-bye. Ain't that the cutest little baby you ever seen, huh?
He's real cute, Billy Joe.
Yeah.
But I was wondering something.
I'm wondering what?
Do you really want your kid growing up talking Mexican like that?
Huh? First of all, Ruby, it ain't Mexican, it's Spanish. And second of all, the way I figured, my son's going to be speaking 5 different languages by the time he's grown up.
How do you figure that?
Well, I can just tell by the way he picks things up. We're going to have an Einstein in our family before you know it.
Well, that must make Nita real happy. At least she seems happy.
She is. She's real happy. We're both real happy. Happy as we've been in weeks.
That's good.
Ruby, how's your apartment hunting going?
I'm still looking.
Oh, come on, it can't be all that bad.
Well, it is when you don't have any more money than I got.
Well, I'll help you out then.
Well, that's not the only problem. I don't want to live too far from the coop.
Ruby, I don't really think you can afford to be too choosy right now.
Why are you in such a rush to get me to move out?
Oh, come on, Ruby. I told you. You know this. You know Nita's not about to move back in with me with you still living at the apartment.
Have you already talked to Nita about moving back in with you?
Well, no, not yet, but seeing as he's been in such a good mood, I was thinking about doing just that today. As a matter of fact, I don't mean you, no offense there, little sister, but I was wondering if you could just kind of get lost for a little while so I could talk to Nita for a little bit, huh?
Okay. I guess I can go back over to the Aquarius and pay Lane a little visit.
Ruby, I don't think that's such a good idea.
Why not?
Well, because I don't want you going over there right now and you hounding her about you moving in with her. She already said no, so just leave it like that.
I wouldn't do that.
Well, good, because that's the last thing Elena needs right now.
I haven't seen Elena since her brother Max is killed. I'm just going to go over there and pay my respects.
I don't have to leave you here if you don't want me to.
Oh, Ricky, I'll be all right. You know, it's just you, me, and Terry now.
And Aunt Maggie.
Does Terry know yet?
Yeah. I talked to Ryan about an hour ago. He's called her already.
She coming in for the funeral?
Yeah, there's a World Oil plane in London that's going to pick her up in Paris and fly her back home.
I guess she's going to want to stay here. This used to be her apartment.
Yeah, well, I don't know about that, but there's plenty of time to work all that out.
How's Rena?
I stopped by the Bellmans earlier today. Rena was up in her room. She wouldn't see anybody. I'm going to go over to Maggie's right now, see how she is. You want to come along?
No, maybe later.
I'll be at the funeral home around 4 or 5. You want me to call you first, or do you just want me to come by and pick you up?
Why don't you call me, and I'll meet you over there. Ricky? Max died for something he believed in.
Yeah. I'll see you later.
Everything's gonna be all right.
Max, he was a wonderful man, Joe. We used to fight a lot, but he was like my father and my brother and everything all rolled into one.
I know.
I wish you could have known him.
Well, I don't think he would have liked me a whole lot, seeing after what I put you through.
No, he would have. I would have made him understand.
Sure you would.
Justin, the well was completely destroyed. I mean, how can they prove that you're slant trailing?
What if it wasn't completely destroyed?
It was. Ryan Connor told me.
Maybe he just told you that.
But why would he do that?
To keep me from destroying any evidence that might have been left behind.
Hey, calm down, sweetheart. You're just not thinking straight. Now, that's not like you.
My darling, if Ryan Connor can nail me, I can go to jail for the rest of my life.
Sweetheart, if Ryan Connor could nail you, he would have already done it. I promise you that.
Not necessarily. You may be trying to take things slowly.
But why?
Because he knows that Iris is out to get him.
No, I don't think so. There is nothing that goes on in this office that I don't know about.
No, Ryan Connor knows that we are engaged. He tried to hide those things from you. You know that.
He couldn't. Now, I think what you ought to do now is just relax and just get on with your business. And the next time that somebody tries to get you involved in a shady deal, I hope that you'll remember what a nightmare this one's been.
Ashley.
Now, listen, Justin, there's no reason that you can't learn from your mistakes. And this slant drilling with Bubba has been the biggest mistake of your entire life.
Are you going to keep reminding me of that?
Yes. From time to time, I will. Justin. Sweetheart, you are smart. And you're clever. And you're charming. And you don't have to be dishonest to be successful. You don't. Just trust your instincts. And you'll be all right. And I'll help you any way I can. Okay?
I know you will.
Hey, listen. I talked to Aunt Hildy, and I told her about our engagement.
What did she say?
Oh, she was thrilled. She said just to let her know when the wedding was going to be, and she'd be available. I want to talk to Mama this morning, too. And she says we have to give her at least a month so she can get all the invitations and make all the arrangements.
Oh, what kind of arrangements have been made for Max Decker's funeral?
None that I know of. Now, listen. How does mid-September sound to you for a wedding date?
Why don't we make your mama happy and have our wedding date around old Christmas or Valentine's Day?
Are you kidding?
No, I'm just very much in love. I always thought that holidays were very romantic times.
Well, hello there, y'all.
Where the hell have you been for 2 days?
It's all right, sweetheart. I'm here now.
Oh, Mama, don't leave me.
I won't leave you.
Do you remember what your dream was about?
I was dreaming about the babies Max and I are going to have. I was at a birthday party for John. We're going to name our first little boy John Maximilian after Daddy, and Max and our little girl Catherine Victoria after you and Kate. Mom, did I ever tell you that?
Yes, you did.
I was at this birthday party for John. It was so lovely. There were candles and the cake and decorations, and all of a sudden, everything caught on fire. Max, I gotta go
honey,
to the hospital.
Honey,
I promise, I'd stay at the hospital.
You don't have to
Daddy
go to the hospital.
Daddy said he'd stay there until I got some rest.
Rena, Max is gone.
No!
You were with him last night when he died.
No! Rena, Max isn't dead! Honey. That was a dream! I wouldn't leave Max!
Honey!
I've got so many plans! We gotta build a house! Honey, we gotta have babies!
Sweetheart!
If he survives you for me, I know you'll get it, Daddy!
Max is gone! The doctors did everything they could, but they couldn't save him. I'm sorry, honey.
Oh,
but you have to accept that.
Oh, you can't leave me now. Oh, you have so many plans. I love him so much.
I know. I loved him too.
It's not fair.
No, it's not. But it's happened. And we have to find a way to deal with it.
The last thing Max said was, I love you. That's how he said goodbye. Oh, Mama. Oh, Mama. Oh, Mama.
This whole thing's such a stupid waste. All could have been avoided so easily. Well, if I kept calling Max until I reached him. Or I could have told you I was going to do another survey and ask you to tell
Ryan,
Max.
Ryan, don't.
Look, I know that if Max knew I was willing to support him...
Ryan, you called Max, and then you had to go out of town.
I know.
You know how angry Max was. Rena didn't even know. Now... it's over. There's no one to blame. Well, if there's anyone to blame, it's Justin.
Justin? Do you know that he wanted to arrest Max for blowing up the well?
Is there any way to prove that Justin was slant drilling?
No, not now, fortunately for Justin.
Do you think that Justin will try to drill another well on the Harper property?
No, I don't think he'd be stupid enough to take that risk again. Besides, he's got development deals going on throughout the South and Southwest now.
Is Bubba Wadsworth in on these deals?
I told Justin that I don't want Bubba associated with World Oil anymore in any way.
You don't even want World Oil to be involved in oil production, do you?
No, that's what Alex wanted to try. I really don't even think I would have objected in the beginning if someone other than Justin had been involved.
Honey, you're the acting president.
I know, but Justin steamrolled development deals through. He's been sending out memos to the officers of the company. And a lot of them seem very excited about the profit potential.
Well, what about risks? You can't expect to... find oil every time you drill.
Well, he seems to have a lot of people thinking that he will strike oil every time he drills.
So you can't stop him now?
Uh-uh, not now. But I can make sure he operates honestly. That's what I intend to do.
Oh, listen, where the hell have you been? I want some answers.
Hey,
I want them now.
Don't start anything in the office now. Mean it.
Ashley, why don't you get out of here so Justin and I can talk, huh? Yeah,
Justin, calm down!
Get your hands out of here!
Hey,
come
stop
on.
It!
Come on, get your hands off of me!
Stop it! Now leave if both of you just calm down. Are you all right?
You all right?
I'm just fine.
Now what in hell are you so riled up about?
Where the hell have you been for the past 2 days since the explosion? Where the hell have you been?
I've been drunk.
For 2 days, Baba?
No, I sobered up, and I didn't want to be around here, so I went to Louisiana to look after our interests there.
What the hell happened at that well that night?
I don't know.
Don't lie to me, Bubba.
I'm not lying to you.
I know you were out at the well site. They found your hat.
at the mud shack. I tried to stop that fool from blowing up the well. We had a fight. And by the time I knocked him out, it was too late to cut the fuse. It was too late to drag him out of there, so I ran away like a crazy man. I suppose that he got blown away, huh?
Yeah, he did die.
Well, when I was in Louisiana, I talked to an old boy who said that Charlie Haskell told him that the well was completely destroyed.
Why couldn't you pick up a phone and tell me that?
Because I thought you already knew.
I've been going crazy here thinking we're going to go to jail, Bubba, you and me.
There is no way. Now, you trust me.
I did. I did once, till I found out you were keeping logs that could prove what we were doing.
Yeah, well, that was a bit of a miscalculation on my part.
Yeah, well, that's an understatement if I ever heard one.
Well, nobody's perfect. Not even me.
Bubba, you did destroy those papers, didn't you?
Well, I'm just sure glad that everything turned out all right.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah. Boy, that Billy Joe Jr. just pulled right through that pneumonia, didn't he, huh? And here we are all back together again. It just seems like old times, doesn't it?
Yeah. Almost.
Of course, I always knew that Billy Joe Jr. was going to be all right. Us rights are pretty tough, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, you are.
Boy, you know, I could tell he was real glad when me and you showed up at the hospital this morning.
Yeah, he was, wasn't he?
Yeah. I guess those nurses treat him pretty well, but I can tell he's real happy to be back with his mommy and daddy.
Look, Billy Joe.
And you know what I think? I think he's real happy that his mom and dad are back together again.
I think I better go check up on him in the kitchen. I don't
know. Honey, he's fine. He's fine. Angie can take a look in on him, you know? You know, everything seems to be working out real well for us now, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Everything seems to be fine.
Well, sure. I mean, I'm back at the coop now, you know, and Mr. Parnell's made me manager of the whole thing. And, Ruby worked out that great arrangement with Ricky and Elena where they can alternate singing like that, and that's worked out real good. Elena hasn't even canceled out once, up till tonight, of course, and that's understandable because of Max.
Mm-hmm. Well, having Ruby around seems to really help you.
Well, yeah, she's got a good head on her shoulders, and she knows what she's doing.
Yeah, she really does.
Of course, well, Ruby gets a little headstrong sometimes, and... Well, you know how it is. She's living with me now, and you know how brothers and sisters get.
Well, you know, I really wouldn't worry about it.
Yeah, but you know what? That doesn't matter now, because she's going to move out real soon. Yeah, she's going to move out real soon, and it's going to just work itself out.
She's moving?
Yeah, real soon.
Well, I didn't know that. Has she found a place?
Well, no, not yet, but she's getting pretty close. You know, Nita, I wanted to talk to you about something. It's real important, you know, and I'll tell you what, why don't you just...
Well, Rick, there's Ricky. I better talk to him, see how he's doing. Oh.
Nita!
You want me to fix you some lunch?
No, I'm not hungry right now.
Are you sure?
Yeah, fix something later.
I don't mind, Joe.
Will you stop worrying about me?
Ugh. Oh. I can't help it. Besides, it helps me keep busy.
I love you, Elena. I'm sorry you got to go through all this. I wish there was something I could do to help you.
Well, it's a help just having you here. You must be going crazy cooped up in this apartment all day long.
Well... If I start to get some cabin fever, I'll just wait until dark, put my disguise on. I don't think anybody could recognize me with the hat and glasses.
Joe, Billy Joe's apartment is just across the complex.
I know. I'll be careful. Damn!
Who is it?
It's Ruby, Elena.
I'll be right there. Hello, Ruby.
I asked you a question, Bubba.
Yeah, well, I heard you. You're the one who's not paying attention. I told you at least 10 times that I took care of those papers from the logbook. I mean, you want me to write in blood or what?
I just want to make sure they don't find any evidence but my...
Nobody's gonna find nothing. Now, will you just cool off and have a cigar?
I hate cigars.
What are you so jumpy about?
I just don't want to have 2 days like the last 2 days. You just better get something straight. Any of these deals that you're involved with me in, you gotta check in with me every 2 hours.
Oh, I don't know. I usually need a little more freedom than that.
Not with me. You just can hang loose with any of your other partners, but with me, you gotta check in. Or you don't work with me. Is that understood?
All right, I'll give it a try. Now let's talk some business.
Tomorrow.
Why not now?
I got some other things I gotta take care of, Bubba.
Are you trying to ace me out or what?
Bubba, I got some other things on my mind right now.
All right, big guy, I'll go over to the Harper place. And I'll just see what we can salvage, and I'll see how long it'll be till that well is operational again.
The well over at the Harper place has been closed down.
What, are you crazy?
Ryan Connor closed it down for good.
Do you have any idea how much oil that well was producing in a single day?
Not enough to go to prison for, Bubba. We're just gonna have to find our oil somewhere else. Get out of here.
I'll see you tomorrow, big shot.
Okay, I'll have Vicky call you when the funeral arrangements are final. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
List of people to call back is getting pretty long, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
You know, I remember Kay once telling me that the Marshalls and the Deckers all went to Grace Church out on Happy Woods Road for almost 100 years.
Hmm. Part of the church burned down. They're trying to restore it, but I don't think they can have a service there yet.
Where do you think it will be, huh?
I imagine it'll be at the chapel at Thomas's funeral home. That's on Happy Woods Road, too.
Well, there's a family plot in the cemetery on the ranch now, isn't there?
Yes, right next to the Marshalls.
Did anyone think to call Barrett?
Kate called him last night. He and Max were very good friends.
I know he must be awfully upset, huh?
He was upset for Max. Not for Rena.
Is he going to be at the funeral?
No.
Why did you figure out how to handle Steve, huh?
Buddy and Wanda didn't want to tell Buddy Jr. about the news about Max, not over the phone.
Yeah, well, that makes sense.
One of us would have to fly up to camp.
Hey, I'll go there if you want me to.
Well, the boys are only supposed to be at that camp another week or so, and I know that if Steve finds out about Max, he'll be pretty upset and want to come home.
Wait till he comes home before you tell him, huh?
I really think that's the best idea.
Is there a chance of them finding out from anyone else up there?
Well, I don't think so. As far as I know, they're the only 2 boys from this area that went to camp. Max was like a father to Steve. I'm all right. Why don't you go ahead and go to the office?
I've got so many appointments today, but... it's the last place I want to be.
All I want to do is get on Songbird and ride until he can't go any further.
How's Rena, huh?
She had a nightmare, but she's calmed down now. She'll sleep for a while.
Vicky, you really need to get some sleep, too.
I don't want to leave Rena alone for too long.
Well, I'll be glad to sit with her, and if she needs you, I'll call you.
All right. Thank you.
Does she still believe that Max is alive?
No, I think she's finally accepted the truth.
I really appreciate you coming over to see how I was doing, Ruby.
Well, I know how you feel. I had a cousin once who was killed in an oil explosion.
Really? Billy Joe never said anything to me about that.
Well, it's a terrible thing. Where's Ricky? I thought he might be over here.
He was here earlier. He said he was going over to Maggie's.
That's funny. We must have just crossed paths. I just came from Maggie's.
He hasn't been gone that long.
You know, Ricky and I were at the barn dance when he got the news about Max.
He told me.
I was wondering why you weren't there, too. I mean, I know you weren't singing at the coop that night.
Well, I was thinking about coming, and I had every intention of going, but at the last minute, I didn't really feel like it, so I decided not to.
It's too bad.
Billy Joe tells me that Billy Joe Jr. is being released from Gulf Coast Hospital today.
Yeah. Nita and Billy Joe are over with Bill Joe Jr. now at Maggie's.
Well, I'm really going to have to get over there today, then. They must be ecstatic.
They are. I think they're finally going to get back together and everything's going to be all right now.
I hope so. You know, Billy Joe talked to me again about moving out and finding a new place to stay.
I don't know what to do. I've been looking in the papers every morning for apartments and there just isn't anything. At least not anything I can afford.
Yes, good apartments are very hard to come by these days.
You know, you really were lucky to have your sister leave you an apartment like this.
Yes, I am. Look, Ruby, I'm sorry about not being able to take you on as my roommate. I hope you understand, but I really need to be alone. I hope you understand that.
Sure. I understand.
I'm glad.
I hope you didn't think for a minute I was hinting in that direction. I know. Sometimes you really just need some time to be alone.
How's Kate?
Well, on the outside, she seemed to be fine, but on the inside, you know how Kate is.
How'd you like seeing your grandson again?
Oh, it was wonderful.
Yeah?
In fact, I think this is about as good a time as any to make my little announcement.
Well, what kind of announcement?
I decided not to go to Amarillo.
What?
Well, at least not anytime soon.
Oh, Maggie! Oh, God! I'm so happy.
I am too, Maggie. That's wonderful.
Well, what made you change your mind?
Oh, I don't know. It just seemed like I needed more here, and, well, besides, I never did find a buyer for the restaurant anyhow.
Well, you are needed here, Maggie.
Well, what about Dwayne?
Oh, he's going to come down to see me just every weekend he can, and any other time he can get away.
Honey, any time for Billy Joe Jr. to take his nap, huh?
Yeah, I guess it is a little past time.
Well, why don't you and me go on up there and put him to bed?
Okay. Oh, wait a minute. Nita... Can I put him to bed just this one time?
Sure.
See, he's just starting life, and right now I think it's real important to see that.
That's just one of Ricky's.
Is it?
Yeah, he must have left it here.
Well, then I ought to take it to him since I'm going right back over to Maggie's now.
Well, I'm going to be seeing him later. I could just give it to him then.
I really don't mind taking it to him, Elena.
I really don't want to put you to all that trouble, Ruby.
Well, it really wouldn't be any trouble.
Look, Ruby, I hope you don't think I'm rushing you out or anything, but I'm feeling pretty tired. I didn't get any sleep last night. I'd like to take a nap.
Sure. I understand.
Thanks, Ruby. I appreciate it.
You know, Lena, I know you and Ricky are going through a terrible time right now. And I just want you to know that if there's anything at all that I can do for you all, you just call me up and let me know, okay?
Yeah, I will. Okay. Thanks, Ruby.
Sure.
Bye-bye. Joe, she's gone.
I don't like that girl.
She didn't mean any harm.
Yeah, I'm not so sure.
She's just being inquisitive.
Sorry, I left this on the living room.
It's all right.
It was stupid.
Well, I think that we pulled one over on her. I told her it was one of Ricky's. So don't worry about it, okay? I gotta go get ready. Mama?
Honey, Ricky's down the hall. You want me to get her for you?
All right. I was just having another dream. I was dreaming about Max. Where is he?
He's at the funeral home.
Is there anybody with him?
Mr.
Stryker's been there most of the day.
That's good. Did you look at him?
No, not yet.
I better go see him, make sure he's all right. Ginny, will you go with me?
Of course I will.
You gotta do something about the funeral.
Do you want me to call Father Boscom for you? I'll be glad to.
No, I'll call him. I gotta talk to Ricky and Elena first. And I gotta call Terry.
Ryan already called Terry.
Is she coming from Paris?
Yes, she's on her way home right now.
You know, I think Max knew something was going to happen to him when he blew up that well.
I think he did, too. When I was dancing with Max at the barn dance, he asked me if I'd always look out for you.
He did?
Yes. Because he was pretty optimistic about your celebration you were going to have right after the dance. He told me about it.
He bought a bottle of champagne. He hates champagne. But he thought that would make it official. Now, wait a minute. I've got to call the contractor. There's no point in building the house now, Max. I wonder how many people will be at the funeral.
You want me to call and find out?
I don't want to see anybody. Do you understand me?
All right. Don't have to go over there right now.
What I'm going to do, Jenny, is I'm going to get on King's Ransom and ride right across the ranch.
Okay. Keep dressed. I'll go with you.
You are leaving now? You all right?
Yeah, I'm okay.
You gonna go out to the funeral home now?
No, I'm gonna go over to Maggie's first, and then Ricky and I are gonna go over there together.
You think Ruby will be at Maggie's?
I don't know. Why?
Because I want you to be very careful what you say around her.
Oh, Joe.
Look. There's something about her, Elena. I don't know what it is, but she asked too many questions.
You used to tell me that I asked too many questions.
Ruby asked different kinds of questions.
Joe, you gotta learn to trust people.
Well, maybe. But I think you gotta learn who you can trust.
Well, I guess you'll be glad to have Aunt Maggie around here for a while longer, huh?
Oh, I sure am. I like Maggie a lot.
Yeah, she's a pretty special lady.
It always seems so funny to me to hear you and Elena call her your aunt.
Why is that?
Well, I don't know. She just doesn't seem like an aunt. I haven't had a chance to tell you how sorry I am about your brother.
Thank you.
Hi, Ricky.
Hi, Ruby.
How you doing?
I'm fine. Billy Joe said you were over to see Elena.
Yeah, I was just there a few minutes ago. I guess you and I just missed each other.
How's she doing?
Yeah, she seemed pretty upset when I was there. I tried real hard to cheer her up as best I could. Where's Nita and Billy Joe?
Oh, they're upstairs with Maggie putting Billy Joe Jr. to bed.
I'm sure glad that Nita was able to bring Billy Joe Jr. home from the hospital today.
Did you see the way Maggie's eyes lit up when Nita brought him in?
I did.
Angela, do you have any iced tea back in the kitchen?
I think so.
I would love a nice tall glass.
Sure. Elena said she might drop by later.
Yeah, I talked to her. In fact, I'm supposed to call her.
Poor Elena. As if she hasn't been through enough already.
Well, she'll be all right.
You look real nice.
Thank you.
You know, I haven't seen you wear that blue work shirt of yours lately.
What blue work shirt is that?
You know, the one with the anchor buttons.
Anchor buttons? I don't have any shirt with any anchor buttons.
You sure?
Of course I'm sure.
I guess I was thinking of one of Billy Joe's shirts then.
Waiter! I'll have another one of these, please. Ashley! How you doing?
Hello. How many drinks have you had?
Oh, just one. Why?
Well, it just looked like you were feeling a lot better.
Well, that's not the drink. It's Bubba. Everything is under control.
Are you sure?
A man who knows Charlie Haskell told Bubba. Charlie's the one that put out the well fire, if you remember. And who knows him told him that the well had been totally destroyed. Now there's no evidence to prove that we'd been doing anything illegal.
All right, so there's no way now that anyone can tell that you were slant drilling.
No, except for those papers from the logbook that were found in the mud shack. I don't know how Bubba could have been so stupid to keep those papers around, but he destroyed them. We're in the clear.
Bubba told you that?
Yep. Now, my dear, there is nothing that can tie us in with the slant drilling. Nothing.
Kept those logs. Ryan Connor, not even sure they exist. Ashley. I bet it's Ashley Lindman.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Texas.
Has Grant come home yet?
Yes, ma'am.
How long ago?
About 15 minutes ago.
I wonder if he saw any horse farms today that looked interesting.
He didn't say.
Oh, I suppose I should apologize to Lacey and him again for not having dinner with them tonight.
Why didn't you ask Dennis to join you here?
I couldn't do that.
Why not?
Never mind why not. I just couldn't, that's all. Vivian, what in heaven's name is so fascinating that you cannot give me your undivided attention for 2 seconds? Where did you get this?
I found it lying by the phone in the study.
I want you to forget you ever saw this.
Why?
Never mind why. Just do as I say.
I'll check in with you later, Alfredo, just in case there are any problems, all right?
I'm sure there won't be, Mrs. Carrington. Oh, have a nice evening.
Thank you. It should be nice to relax for a while. I'll talk to you later.
Okay. Hi. Quitting so early?
As a matter of fact, I was.
Something come up?
No, just been a hectic day, so I decided to take the night off.
Good. Good. Then we can have dinner again.
Oh, I'd love to, Peter, but I've already had dinner.
Well, how about a movie then?
Oh, I'm going to the theater tonight.
Alone?
Oh, no, not alone. Thank you. With Elliot Carrington.
And you can get me another one of those, if you would.
Hey.
Thank you.
Hey. Don't you think you've had enough to drink?
I'm celebrating my freedom. From worry, freedom from prison, from poverty.
If you're planning on getting drunk tonight, I think I'll just go on home, okay?
Okay. All right, I'll stick with the club soda.
All right.
We'll just have a nice, quiet dinner here, and then we'll go back to my place and spend a nice, quiet evening. How's that?
That's fine. Anyway, I really don't feel like spending a whole lot of time around other people.
Because of Max Decker's death?
Yes.
You didn't even know him that well. Why are you so disturbed, Ashley?
If you don't know, Justin, there's no sense in me even trying to explain it to you.
You're not much fun when you're in a mood like this.
Fine. I'm going to go on home. I'll see you in the morning, okay?
That's a terrible idea, Ashley.
Oh, great. Now, this is all I need.
Hey, Justin. I just ran into your secretary on the elevator, and she asked me to give you this.
Oh, this is about that Mississippi deal. Excuse me, I'll take care of this one right now.
Yeah, well, you take your time. I and Mrs. Linden will find something to talk about. Look here. I know you got those papers from my logbook. I want them back.
Starring Beverly McKenzie.
What's so important about that piece of paper?
Nobody said it was important.
It must be if you want me to forget I saw it.
All right. If you must know, it's a list of the members of the Board of World Oil.
Oh.
Aren't you going to ask what I'm doing with
it? I have a feeling I don't really want to know.
I told you before I was going to befriend members of the board. It's part of my effort to oust Ryan Connor as head of the company.
I thought you'd given up on that.
You know me better than that.
Mr. Grant Wheeler is going to be awfully upset with you if he finds out what you're up to.
Mr. Grant Wheeler isn't going to find out, is he, Vivian?
Mrs. Wheeler, do you really think Mr. Connor is responsible for your husband's death?
I don't think so. I know so.
How are you planning to get Mr. Connor out of World Oil? You only own a third of the company.
Dennis has promised to help me.
Are you sure about that?
Those were his exact words.
You're right, Mrs. Wheeler. I should forget about that piece of paper.
Yes, I think that would be very wise.
Oh, Mrs. Wheeler.
Well, what is it now?
You and Mr. Wheeler are just starting to speak to each other again after that awful argument you had about trying to get Mr. Connor arrested. He's going to be so upset when he finds out what you're doing.
Upset? About what? So, you're going to the theater with Elliot Carrington. A charming.
Yes, it should be very pleasant. I'm looking forward to it.
Yes, I'm sure you are.
It's a summer theater. KVIK is doing a special report on it.
And are you part of the report? Haven't heard from you since you moved out.
I haven't heard from you either.
Well, I figured since you were the one who left, it was up to you to call.
I didn't think it was necessary to call, Peter. I assumed I would see you here at the top of the World Club.
Oh, come on, don't give me that page. You didn't call because you didn't want to see me.
That's not true.
No.
Why did you come here?
I came to see you.
So you've seen me.
Don't you get smart with me.
I don't know what you expect from me, Peter. I don't know what you want me to say.
It was very good to you.
I haven't forgotten that.
I took you in when you had nowhere else to go.
I've already told you that I was grateful.
Then for God's sake, act it.
We've been over this before, Peter. You want something from me, I can't give you.
But you're willing to give it to Elliot Carrington, isn't that it?
Did you come here to cause a scene?
No. No, I came to find out whether you thought you could really just use me the way you did and then just
dump me when you were through with me?
I didn't use you. You were the one who asked me to come move in.
Yeah, well, I don't remember your having too many other offers.
I've already told you I was grateful, Peter. What more do you want? Now, look, I work here. I don't want an argument, all right? Not now.
So, you just move out on me and jump right into the old bed with your father-in-law.
I have never slept with an Elliot.
Sure, it's just a matter of time.
We're just good friends.
Oh, come on, Paige. I've heard that one before. It's in all the Hollywood newspapers. Blah, 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 blah. Just good friends. We all know what that means.
If you'll excuse me, we're going to have to continue this discussion later. I'm going to be late.
What papers, Bubba? I don't even know what you're talking about.
You know what I mean, all right. The papers from the logbook.
Now, what in the world would I want with papers from your logbook?
To use as evidence? To prove that I was slant drilling over to the Harper place?
Now, what makes you think that I have those papers?
Because they were in a file in Justice's office.
Hey, I'm not Justin's secretary.
No, maybe not, but I think you knew about them, and I think you've got them.
Well, you're wrong, Bubba. You're wrong. It's all right. He's not staying.
You think you're pretty smart, don't you?
Yeah. I'm fairly intelligent.
Well, what do you plan doing with those papers?
Now, Bubba, I don't plan to do anything with those papers because I don't have those papers.
You sure only want those papers. Hear me, anyone. And I'll see your lover boys in jail so quick your head'll spin.
Yeah. Is that why you kept them, Bubba? So you could blackmail Justin?
No, I just didn't have a chance to destroy them.
Oh, how convenient for you. Let me tell you something, Bubba. Those papers can put you in prison just as quick as Justin.
Yeah, well, maybe that's why it's, not a good idea for them to be around.
Well, now, I don't know about that, because whoever did get them must have thought there'd be some use for them.
Who you plan to use them on? Me or Justin?
Well, now, Bubba, if I wanted to get you, all I'd have to do is tell Justin about those papers. Tell him I found them. You'd be out of here in 5 minutes.
No, I don't think so. I don't think you're going to do that. I think you're going to hang on to him. Just in case Justin ever tries to get rid of you. He's looking at you.
I have to go back to the kitchen.
Vivian,
I can practically guarantee something's burning on this stove.
What is this that Vivian supposes I'm going to be so upset about?
Oh, she just thinks I shouldn't be leaving you and Lacey to dine alone tonight, and I do apologize,
Greg. Oh, no, there's nothing to explain about that. I understand. But I do wish that Dennis had come over for dinner sometime. I'd like to get to know my nephew a little bit better.
Of course.
Would you like a drink before dinner?
Oh, all right, thank you.
Is Elliot meeting you and Dennis?
No.
The Bellmans?
Dennis and I are dining alone tonight.
Alone?
That's right.
Well, then, why don't you have Dennis come over here? I'm sure that Lacey would love to spend some time with him.
Oh, not tonight, Grant. It's not a good time. Some other night. Dennis and I have some very serious matters to discuss this evening.
He's not in trouble, is he?
No, not that I'm aware of.
Well, I'm glad to hear that. I was hoping things would turn out well for him now that he's been cleared of the murder charge.
I certainly hope so, too.
Iris, is there something wrong? You're not in trouble, are you?
I might as well tell you now. You're bound to find out sooner or later.
Find out what?
There's a board of directors meeting scheduled for next week at World Oil. Dennis has promised to help me in removing Ryan Connor as head of the company.
Good evening, Mr. Carrington.
Hi, Al. Is my mother here?
No, she's not.
I'll wait for her at the bar, then.
Where's Paige?
Haven't you heard? She's out with your father for a night on the town.
I don't have to blackmail Justin to keep him. Now, why don't you just run along, Bubba?
Maybe you and I can make a deal.
I've already told you. I don't have the papers. And even if I did, I don't make deals with trash.
Who are you calling trash?
You. Take a good, long, hard look at yourself.
What makes you think you're so high and mighty, sister? You're just like everybody else. You're out for anything you can get.
Don't raise your voice, Bubba. Didn't your mama teach you not to raise your voice?
All right. You won this round, Sugar Pie. But I'm warning you. I'm going to get those papers. One way or another.
What was Bob in such a hurry about?
Morty, I don't know. Probably had to go honky-tonking or something. Did you make your deal?
Yeah, I have an idea. Let's go out to the ranch.
That is a terrible idea.
Oh, Ashley.
It's just not the time, Justin, to see your grandmother. I mean, she's absolutely devastated over Max's death.
Oh, it's the perfect time. I want to console
you. Oh, sweetheart.
Come on, Ashley.
Cooled off a lot, don't you think?
Yes, it has. Did you go up to check on your granddaddy?
He's not there. He's probably off drinking someplace, trying to drown his sorrows in whiskey.
All this must have been very hard on him.
Granddaddy's upset for all the wrong reasons. He's sorry because he isn't going to be rich anymore. Not because Max. Because Max.
No, it's all right, Lurline. It's all right. Come on now. Let's go sit down.
I've been trying so hard to cheer you up, Miss Kate. All I ever seem to be doing is bursting into tears.
There's nothing wrong with tears, Lurline. The nature's way of washing away sorrow. And you've been a very great comfort to me.
You know, I fell in love with Max Decker when I was 7 years old. I loved him ever since.
I know that, Lurline. Max knew it, too.
I'm glad. If you're hungry, I'll fix you some supper.
Well, why don't we just go fix something together?
I'll let you know as soon as your table is ready, Mr. Carrington.
Thanks, Al.
Buy you a drink?
No, thanks.
Looks like we're both having dinner alone tonight.
Looks that way, doesn't it?
You know, you've been very good to that wife of yours.
Have I?
Sure. Talking your mother into letting her have her old job back here at the top of the World Club. Not to mention letting her move back into Alex Wheeler's old suite.
Well, that was the least I could do since she refused to take a settlement.
Yes. Very noble of her, didn't you think?
Look, if it's all the same to you, I'd rather not discuss it.
I'm amazed at how well disposed you are towards her, considering everything she's done to you. Now, taking up with your father?
Look, I think that's enough.
Well, I think you're talking to the wrong person. I think you should be telling that to Paige.
I see. And your dinner with Dennis tonight is to plot the strategy as to how to remove Ryan from World Oil.
We don't have to do much plotting. Between us, Dennis and I control 2/3 of the company. It should be a fairly easy matter to settle. I wanted to tell you, Grant, but I knew you'd be against it.
You're absolutely right. I am against it. Iris, I can't believe that you're serious about this.
That's because you refuse to see what Ryan is really like.
Oh, I think I've got a pretty good idea what Ryan is really like. He's a decent, hard-working young man who's done one hell of a job for World Oil.
Well, it seems you've made up your mind.
Yes, I have.
And I've made up my mind, too.
Iris, if you oust Ryan, that company's going to fall apart.
Oh, I don't agree. I think Justin Marshall would do an excellent job running World Oil.
Well, for all I know, Justin's a very able man, but he doesn't have the experience to run the whole company. As a matter of fact, there's only one man that has that experience, and that's Ryan.
World Oil needs someone with vision. Someone who will carry on the dreams that Alex had for the company. Justin has that vision and drive.
Ryan was Alex's right-hand man. Alex trusted him. He knows that company inside out.
Ryan killed my husband.
That's not true,
Iris.
It
is true.
Iris, for the fifth time, you don't have one single shred of evidence to support that allegation. You're treading on very dangerous ground.
I don't care if it's dangerous or not. Ryan is a ruthless man who will stop at nothing to get what he wants. He wants World Oil, and I'm not going to let him have it.
Sure you won't have dinner with me?
What is it you want?
Well, I just think we have a lot to talk about. We have a lot in common.
We don't have a thing in common.
You know, I admire you.
I'm sure.
Oh, I do. You know how to treat a woman like Paige.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm talking about the scene you caused the last time your wife and I were having dinner together here at the Top of the World Club. Calling Paige a tramp like that in public? Took a lot of nerve.
I was angry. People say things they don't mean.
Sure. Only a lot of times, those things are true. Come on, you have every right in the world to be angry at that wife of yours.
I'm not angry anymore.
I don't believe that. I don't think you believe it either.
Believe what you want to believe.
That woman almost caused you to spend 5 years of your life in prison. Now, one doesn't get over something like that very quickly. Then, lying to you about her past...
Doesn't matter anymore.
And now? Taking up with your own father.
Look, I told you not to say that.
To say what? The truth? Come on, man. You know it's true. She's after your father now the same way she was after you. When she thought you stood to inherit the Wheeler fortune. She'll probably get it, too. I mean, women like Paige usually get what they want unless someone stops them.
Look, what Paige gets or doesn't get doesn't matter to me anymore. She runs her own life.
I don't believe you. I think you'd love to get even with Paige. Come on, you despise her. It's written all over your face. I know, because I see that same face in the mirror every morning.
Get lost.
Sure, I'll get lost. Only you think about what I was just telling you. You know, Paige thinks she's really got it knocked. But you and I, together, put a pretty good-sized monkey wrench in her plans. You know, I know a great deal about Paige. That porno flick
was only the beginning. You think about it.
I think we'll warm the chicken casserole, Lurline. Ginny tells me you're thinking about getting an apartment in town.
Yeah, I was thinking about it.
Why do you want to live in town?
I don't know. I just thought I'd like to try out the big city. I can't do that now. There's no money since the well was blown up.
Do you need money, Lurline?
No, no. I saved enough to get through college and to pay the taxes on the land. Granddaddy might have saved some, too, but I doubt it.
Well, I'm glad you've saved some. It's a nice feeling to have a little money in the bank.
Well, mine isn't exactly in the bank yet. I've been meaning to open an account. I'll do it one day this week.
But, Lurline, you mustn't have that much cash in the house.
Don't worry, Miss Kay. It's hidden real well. Besides, if anybody took a look at our house, they'd never dream there was anything valuable inside.
Well, but even so, your money would be earning interest for you in the bank.
I know. I learned all about that in this accounting course I took. Guess I just got busy. You know, it's funny. We take things for granted. Assume that life will go on and nothing will ever happen to disturb it.
Life will go on, Lurline. Whatever happens.
I know. It just seems so empty now without Max.
That's true. But in time, other people will come along to help fill that emptiness.
No one will ever be able to fill Max's place, Miss Kate, not for any of us.
No. No one can ever fill his place. But in time, there are other people who will come along, who will come into our lives in their own right. And after a while, some of the pain will go away.
I don't think it'll ever go away completely.
Well, it doesn't, Lurline. But you just have to live with it and accept it.
You know, Max was such a good person. I don't think he ever hurt anyone in his whole life. How could God have let him die, Miss Kate?
God has his own plans, Lurline. It's not for us to question them. And he never takes anything away from us without giving us something in exchange. You've just got to learn to look for them.
Somehow that makes me feel better.
Good. Lurline, I've been meaning to ask you something.
What is it?
Ginny tells me you're afraid to stay up at your place. What are you afraid of, Lurline?
I'm not afraid. Not anymore.
Well, I thought I'd see Grandma sitting right here on the porch.
Good. I think we ought to turn around and head right back to Houston.
We just got here, Ashley. Take a look around, see if there's any changes you want made.
Changes?
Yeah.
For what?
Oh, in the house.
Why, Justin, this isn't my house.
Ashley, I plan to live here. When we're married, I want those renovations completed.
Well, now, Justin, you own 40% of this ranch, but 60% of it is owned by Courtney Barrett, your grandmother. Your grandmother controls the ranch, and she doesn't even want you out here for a visit, let alone to live here.
I don't think it'll be too long at all before this place belongs to me.
What are you up to now, Justin?
Oh, you're sounding just like Grandma asked.
I want to know.
It's really very simple. Now that I can't drill on the Harper place, I'm going to drill right here.
And just how are you planning on doing that?
I'll find a way. First, I'll try to make peace with Grandma.
Uh-uh. No, you'll try to make trouble. And I'm not going to be a part of it.
Would you like a drink?
No, thank you. I'll have wine with dinner.
Nothing for me, thanks. What's wrong?
Nothing.
You've been in this mood ever since you got here.
I'll be fine. I wonder where Paige is tonight.
She went to the theater with Dad.
With Elliot?
That's right. Does that bother you?
No. Why should it?
He was your husband for a long time.
And that was a long time ago. Elliot is certainly free to do as he likes. Does it bother you?
No, why should it?
Are you and Paige on friendly terms again?
I don't think I'd go quite that far.
Have you seen her?
I see her when I come here for dinner. That's about it.
Oh, I hope you realize just how fortunate you are to be rid of that woman. She was a catastrophe.
Look, if it's all the same to you, I just assume we didn't talk about Paige.
And why is that?
You don't give up, do you?
All right, darling, we won't talk about Paige.
Thank you.
What would you like to talk about?
Whatever it was you wanted to talk about when you called me and asked me to meet you here.
Do I have to have a reason to want to have dinner with my son?
Why aren't we having dinner at your house?
Because there are certain things I can't talk to you about in front of Grant.
That's what I was afraid of. And what are those certain things?
There's a board meeting at World Oil next week.
I'm aware of that.
You made me a promise. You told me you'd help me oust Ryan as head of the company.
Did I say that?
You know you did.
Well, if I did, it doesn't matter. Because I've changed my mind.
Not through working.
You've been working since 4 o'clock this morning.
I know it.
Don't you think it's time you stopped?
I don't want to stop because if I stop, I'm going to start thinking, and I don't want to do that.
I can understand that. I can't stop thinking about Max.
I could have stopped Max from dying, but I didn't. I can't get that in my head. You understand?
You tried, Jeff. You couldn't have done anything else. He knocked you out.
I didn't try hard enough. I could have handled it different.
What's good's it going to do if you keep blaming yourself? It was not your fault that Max died.
I can't stop. I can't stop feeling guilty.
Jeff, look, I probably could have done more, too, and I didn't. But it's over now.
I just keep thinking. Max is going to walk through this door here.
I know. I feel the same way. When I was coming down here, I kept thinking I was going to run into him going back to the cabin. Did you see Jenny and Rena this morning?
Yeah, I saw them. I saw them riding across the pasture, but I made sure I was gone before they got back there.
Why?
What am I supposed to say to Rena? How am I going to ever face her?
We're going to have to face her sometime. Just tell her you're sorry about Max. She'll understand the rest of it.
You're right.
You're right. That fire go all the way up to your place?
No. It's a real mess up there. Have you seen it?
No, I haven't. I'll come up and help you clean up there.
That's real nice of you, Jeff. You know what I'd really like? If you'd help me plant some trees to replace the ones that were destroyed.
Sure. Okay, you just tell me where you want them, how many you want. Get some of the other boys to help out, too.
I think we'll wait until Justin and Bubba clean up the well site and take that construction trailer away.
When do you think that's going to be?
I don't know. Can't be too soon for me. I don't want Bubba Wadsworth to have any reason to ever come back to my place again. I don't care if I ever lay eyes on Justin Marshall again either.
Hello, Grandma.
Why didn't you hear your car drive up?
Well, we came in the front way. I just gave Ashley a tour of the ranch.
Mrs. Marshall, I was so sorry to hear about Max. I know how much he meant to you.
Your concern sounds almost genuine.
It is. Max dying was a great tragedy.
Yes, Grandma, it was a terrible tragedy.
Doesn't seem to have affected you much.
Well, with Barry gone and now Max, I was just concerned about your running the ranch by yourself, Grandma.
Now, you can save your concern, Justin. I've run this ranch before by myself. I can do it again.
Well, you're not a young woman anymore, Grandma.
That may be true. But I've got a few good years left yet. And I'm going to spend them taking care of this ranch and preserving the pasture lands for future generations.
The future belongs to my children, Grandma.
Well, I was thinking of young Steve and the children Courtney might have, and Ginny and Ryan. And Barry, if he ever remarries.
Will my kids share this love you have for the ranch, too, Grandma?
Children tend to learn that kind of love from their parents.
So you're writing me off, are you, Grandma? Is that it?
Yes, I have.
I own 40% of this ranch, Grandma. You better remember that, too.
Well, you might as well sell it. Because you're never going to get control of this ranch. Courtney won't sell, Barry won't sell, and Lord knows I won't sell. And if you're waiting for me to die, Justin, I might as well tell you right now that I'm leaving my share of the ranch to Ginny, Ryan, and their children. Ryan's already bought 10 acres to build their house on. And I may just give him what shares I have left as a wedding present.
I think I'll have that drink after all. Thanks.
Don't do this to me.
Do what?
You told me you'd help me.
The best way I can help you is to stop you from carrying out this crazy scheme you have of kicking Ryan Connor out of World Oil.
Dennis, you promised.
I didn't promise. Besides, I'm not going to do it.
You have to.
I like Ryan. He runs World Oil as well as anyone could. Besides, you and I both derive a healthy income from that company. And I see no reason to upset that situation.
Oh, no?
Well, I can think of one very good reason.
And what's that?
Paige, you came to me and begged me to allow her to return to work here and to let her move back into Alex's suite. Well, if you don't stand behind me on this, I'll have her thrown out tonight.
Go ahead.
I mean it, Dennis.
Oh, I'm sure you do. But I don't care. If that's what you want to do, you go right ahead and do it.
I don't believe you. If you didn't care about it, you wouldn't have asked me to do it in the first place.
I've already accomplished what I set out to do. If you fire Paige now from the top of the World Club, you're the one who's going to look bad, not me.
what's come over you, Dennis? This isn't like you.
I suppose there are those who would say I'm just being my mother's son.
I know you haven't approved of everything I've done, but I've done it all for you.
How sweet.
What are you hoping to accomplish by this?
Yeah, well, I don't ever want to see Justin or Bubba either.
I'm so sorry that you and Max weren't able to prove that Bubba was slant drilling.
Yeah, well, somebody's going to prove it one day here real soon.
I hope so.
You never told me why you were afraid of Bubba.
He's just not a very nice person, that's all. Lacey Wheeler turned out to be kind of nice, didn't she?
Yeah. Yeah, she did.
Did you call her?
No, I haven't. I'm going to call her one of these days here soon. How's Caleb?
Well, he was over Miss Kate this afternoon to offer his sympathies.
I really appreciate you spending time with Kate like that now. I mean, she means a lot to her. Thanks.
Have the country stop by. She really doesn't need me. Jenny just asked me to look after her while she stayed with Rena. You know, I have a feeling that she'd like to spend some more time with you, Jeb. When's she coming on up to the house for supper?
Okay, I will.
You sold Ryan Connor 10 acres?
Jenny and Ryan.
Did Barry agree to that?
I didn't ask him. I talked to Courtney and Dawn, and they said it was all right.
I own Dawn's shares. Ryan Connor's not going to build on my land. And he's not going to take this ranch away from me.
You don't seem very happy at the prospect of having to fight with Ryan Connor. I guess you think the odds are better fighting me.
We're talking about family here, Grandma. Ryan Connor is not family.
Jenny is family.
By marriage only.
Jenny is more of a Marshall than you ever thought of being. And I'd rather have a Connor running this ranch as it is than a Marshall turning it into an oil field.
The only way Ryan Connor will ever run this ranch is over my dead body.
Go back to Houston, Justin. You don't belong here. You've never cared about this land or your family or honesty, fidelity, or truth. Go chase your dreams of gold in the city where they understand them. Where dreams of gold are more important than Max Decker's life. Because you killed him, Justin, but you're not going to kill me. And you're not going to take this land from me. I'll never let that happen.
Come on, Scott.
No, no. You're wrong, Grandma. I didn't kill Max Decker. He killed himself. I have no intention of apologizing for wanting a better life for my children and their children that come after. I'm not trying to kill you. Grandma, I love you. I only want what I'm entitled to. Times have changed, Grandma. A loaf of bread doesn't cost a nickel anymore. Texas isn't just for grazing land. I'm not forgetting about the past, but I'm not going to close my eyes to the future either. If you don't want to share in my inheritance, I'll find a way to have it all on my own. I'm going to return the Marshall name to its proper place in this state. I don't want to fight you, Grandma, but I will. And I'll win.
There's no way you can win, Justin.
There's no way you can win, Justin.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Texas.